four judges who approved the Carter Page FISA warrants were all nominated by Republican presidents. And Republican Senator Marco Rubio says there was a reason, he believes, to keep an eye on Page.
Yeah, I have a different view on this issue than the president in the White House. They did not spy on the campaign from anything and everything that I have seen. We have a guy here who's always in Russia, brags about Russia, and we have reason to believe, and they list those reasons why this is someone we should be watching, and they follow the legal process by which to do so.
All right, let's bring in Congressman Matt Gaetz, a Florida Republican, another Florida Republican. Do you agree with your counterpart there on the Senate side, Marco Rubio?
Well, I admire Marco Rubio a great deal. I used to work for him, but I take a different view for a few reasons. First, if Carter Page was truly engaging in these activities for years, why was there not surveillance of Carter Page for years? Obviously, this was a consequence of his involvement with the Trump campaign and the desire to collect surveillance on the Trump campaign. Second major problem, the government leads with the dossier. I'm a litigator. Every litigator knows you lead with your best evidence. But for the dossier, there never would have been the authority to spy on someone that's close to the campaign. Third major problem are the omissions. You never see the Hillary Clinton campaign or the DNC even mentioned when it comes to their relationship to paying for this dossier. You also don't see that Nellie Orr, the wife of Bruce Orr, a senior Justice Department official, was working on this, and then Bruce Orr was the person who valeted the political information into the intelligence spectrum. So for those three reasons, I would take a different view from my mentor, my good friend Marco Rubio.
I would say this weekend when the FISA stuff went public, I immediately was trying to read it myself, and my Twitter feed was split down the middle. On the left, they were claiming victory. On the right, they were claiming victory. Each side saying what they read there proved their points. I want to play a little bit more of what Congressman Schiff, the ranking member on House Intel on the Democrats, what he had to say tonight. Give you a chance to respond.
This is a false, patently false, provably false statement, but not just by Nunes. Others signed off on it too, like Trey Gowdy, and indeed the entire majority signed off on that Nunes memoranda.
Patently false statements by you and others.
Yeah, look, this FISA application has become like an inkblot test where Republicans and Democrats both look at it and see what they want to see. Let's start with an area where we should have broad bipartisan agreement. If a political party or a political candidate pays for opposition research, and that opposition research before a secret court with no adversarial attorney on the other side is the basis to go spy on someone, regardless of who it comes from, I think that should be disclosed. I think we should know that. And this vague reference to the fact that Christopher Steele didn't like Donald Trump is not sufficient to show the Democratic Party's involvement. So I think that that is an area where we should find broad agreement. Now, Adam Schiff himself introduced legislation to have more transparency in the FISA court. He did that when Barack Obama was president. I introduced that exact same legislation in this Congress, and Adam Schiff won't even co-sponsor his own bill. It shows the extent to which there's far too much partisanship in how people are evaluating the facts. And if Democrats or Republicans come up with good ideas, we ought to be able to work together so that we don't see this happen in the future.
I don't see it happening on this anytime soon, but let me read you this from the Washington Post. The headline said, with the release of new documents, Devin Nunes' memo on Carter Page has gotten even less credible. Then inside the piece it says, from the evidence at hand, though, it's certainly fair to assume that it's Nunes' memo, not the warrant application, that suffered from a stronger political bias in its creation.
Well, I would encourage everyone to go and look at the piece that Byron York did in the Washington Examiner, where he broke down every paragraph of the Nunes memo, and then he went through the information in the FISA application that justified those claims. The most significant claim is that information went from the DNC to the spouse of a Justice Department official into an application, and then formed the basis of that application, and then was validated by a Yahoo News article by Michael Isikoff that was planted by Christopher Steele. That Yahoo News article cited four times in the first 30 pages of the FISA application.
Why do you think the left is looking at the same information and claiming victory?
It's pretty bizarre to me. Again, I think that unfortunately we're at a place in our country where we can only view things through the lens of Trump. If you're for Trump, you think one way. Against Trump, you think the other way. I think we need broader transparency throughout this process. I know Adam Schiff believes the same thing because he filed a bill to do it, but now he won't back his own legislation. Very bizarre.
I would say the Byron New York piece is a very good read. If you want to go, like you said, paragraph by paragraph of Chairman Nunes' memo and compare that against what we see in the FISA documents, there's a ton that's redacted that we just can't know. Whether we get any more of that or not, I don't know.
I think we will. I think the president wants to see full transparency here, and I think you're going to see a lot more information declassified. We wouldn't even have this information if President Trump hadn't declassified the Nunes memo.
You are probably right about that. All right, Congressman, great to have you in.
Thank you, Shannon.